Gentlemen, Mayank here, and I'm back in the gym doing one of my favorite workout splits and few of my favorite exercises. I'll just walk you through my workout because there is no point explaining you my workouts, explaining you my exercises. Because I think most of you are lifters here already, you know what to do, you know how to do. I'll just tell you what I do and I'll just explain you my whole workout split. So as you see right now, I'm doing pause deadlifts. These are my warm-up sets, 135 on the bar, and this is a method developed by a champion powerlifter, Pete Rubish, who recently performed this and showed this to Mark Bell. Yes, if you don't know who Mark Bell is, I don't know what's wrong with you. Check out supertraining.tv, one of the finest fitness and bodybuilding and powerlifting channels on YouTube. Check it out, you'll have tons of great videos to watch there. This is one of their techniques. What I'm doing right now is I'm pausing the weight an inch or two above my foot and I'm pulling it up and I'm controlling my negative as hard as I can. This is 185, again 5 reps, but very controlled rep with a pause from the ground. I'll move on to some prep sets, then I'll do one main set of around 5 to 6 repetitions. I like doing it this way because it is a lot more easier and less taxing on my nervous system. And I'm not pausing anymore. I have my belt on, no chalk yet, no strap yet. I don't deadlift with my straps, so no chalk yet. My belt is on and I'm just doing regular conventional deadlifts. 5 reps or 3 to 5 reps, really controlled negative, and that was my prep set. This is 265 pounds on the bar. This is my only and my final set of about 5 to 6 reps. I think I pulled 5 reps in this set, I guess. Let's see. My lower back is steady and strong. I think I'm doing fine with my lower back. Okay, there was a little hike in my lower back. See, you have to notice one thing. If you are a tall guy, if you're anything above 6 foot or 5 foot 11, it is okay to have a little rounding in your back when you're training for your 5 rep or 6 rep maxes. It is so because you tend to have long hamstrings and you use a lot of your hamstrings and your lower back instead of your glutes. So it's okay to have that slight little bend or rounding in your lower back. Just a slight of it though. And that is only when you're doing your 3 to 4 rep maxes. Not when you're doing 8 to 10 rep maxes. Moving on, these are some pull-ups. I don't really like machines. I don't really like the lat pull-down machines. I would rather have some practical strength. And I don't think doing lat pull-down on a machine will give me any kind of practical or applicable strength. So I like doing pull-ups. I'll do 3 sets of about 8 to 10 reps or as many reps as I can. This is my 3rd set, I guess. I did about 7 to 8 reps. As you see, I'm struggling really hard. I need to up my pull-up game, but that was about my pull-ups. Then I did some seated cable rows. These are really good for the middle back and upper back, middle and upper back, the whole of the rhomboid section, if you may say so. The weight was, I think, 245 pounds. I mean, I was lifting the full stack for about 15 to 14 reps and it did feel challenging at the 15th and 14th rep. So I would maybe add future weight in that thing and do much more heavier weights, but we'll see to that later. Now this is one of my favorite exercises of all time. These are dumbbell shirks, and those, my friend, those are the heaviest dumbbells of my gym. 150 pound dumbbells. I don't know why nobody uses it. I saw it, I got excited, I had the camera rolling, so why not just do it for the fun sake. I did about 10 reps of that, 2 sets, 10 reps of that, and that felt really good. Anyway, this is again one of the very crucial exercises. This is to make your deadlift even stronger. These are hyper extensions. Now, since I have a relatively strong back compared to my entire body, I have to add on some more resistance. So I have this 115 pound weight there. I am trying to build resistance on that and I'm trying to squeeze my lower back as hard as I can on that eccentric motion. Like whenever I'm up at this eccentric, I'm trying to hold my stance there, I'm trying to hold my position there, and I'm trying to stretch my lower back as hard as I can. I did this for 2 sets, about 5 to 7 reps till failure, and that was about it. Anyway, finishing it off with some rear delts. Many of you may have complaints about not doing rear delts or ignoring your rear delts. I used to do the same. I'm not really a fan of training rear delts and forearms in specific, but I have seen some significant improvement in my deadlifts by training these smaller and weaker muscles. So I want to have a stable, strong upper body, therefore I was training my rear delt for the same. Those were rear flies. I did two sets of about 15 to 20 reps. Moving on, one of my favorite arm workouts, I have to grow my spaghetti arms. My arms are really small, about 14 inches. I need to grow an inch or an inch and a half by the year's end. I mean, by the next February 2017, guys, if I don't have a 15 and a half inch arm, then I'm not gonna make workout videos anymore. So that's one of my major goals. Besides improving my major lifts like squats, deadlifts and bench press and shoulder press, I have to have big, nice arms. So that was for my bicep, and this is parallel bars or dips, as you may call, for my triceps. I have been thinking of doing this for quite some time. I'll be training my biceps and triceps almost every workout now. Doesn't matter if I'm doing my legs, chest, back or whatever. Like, I have a 3-day split now. I do my chest, back and leg kind of a split day, push, pull and leg. So doesn't matter what I'm doing, I'll be training my arms. I'll just do one exercise for 3 sets and I'll be done. But I have to do it every day. I really want that puppy to grow. Anyway, that was it for the video, guys. If you did really like it, if you did find it helpful, let me know whatever it is in the comment section box below. I'll go make some more videos and have some post-workout meal. I'll see you soon in the next video. Don't forget to subscribe to the channel. Don't forget to leave a comment. Don't forget to check out my Facebook, Twitter, Instagram and Snapchat for more of these workout and other fancy styling and sexiness. I'm Mayank Bhattacharya. Thanks a lot for watching. I'll see you soon in the next video.